What if I told each and every one of you that you have access to something that could improve your heart health, make you happier and less depressed, improve your performance, and maybe even help you lose weight? Would you want to learn about that? Well, I'm Dr. Rita Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and I'm going to tell you exactly what that superpower is and how you can access it. Sleep. In previous videos, I've talked about how to boost your testosterone naturally. Sleep is critically important. Well, today I'm going to convince you guys that sleep is super important for so many different aspects of your quality of life, and trying to prioritize your sleep and get rid of bad habits can really go a long way. The American Academy of Sleep Medicine and the Sleep Research Society recommend getting 7 or more hours of sleep for optimal health. How many of you sleep more than 7 hours at night? Pause the video and comment below. I'm gonna guess that a third of you are not getting enough sleep. Before we get into why sleep is important, let me talk a little bit about sleep. So how do our bodies know when it's time to sleep? Well, all of us have an internal clock. It's called the suprachiasmatic nucleus, and it's in the brain. And this responds to the amount of daylight around us to tell us when it's awake time and when it's time to go to sleep. This is called the circadian rhythm. But interestingly, everyone's circadian rhythm is not the same. So you all know somebody who is a really good early morning person, wakes up bright and excited to take on the day. And there's other people who would sleep till noon if they could. And that's because we have variations in chronotype. So this was actually a survival advantage. You can think back to when we didn't have modern day society and we lived in maybe tribes and didn't have security systems. So at that point, people had to take turns staying awake throughout the night so that they could oversee and make sure that the tribe was safe. And so it made sense that some people would be better at sleeping later in the morning and some people would be better sleeping earlier at night. And this also tends to change over a lifetime. So if you all have ever been a teenager or have any teenage children, you'll realize that they never want to get out of bed before noon. That's because their chronotype is optimized to be waking up in the late morning. In addition to our exposure to light and our chronotype, there's another chemical that builds up in our brains called adenosine. And when you wake up in the morning, you've got a clean slate, no adenosine. And throughout the day, adenosine builds up and builds up. And as it continues to build up, you get more and more sleepy. Interestingly, caffeine blocks adenosine so that we don't get that fatigue feeling. However, once the caffeine wears off, all the adenosine rushes back, which causes the caffeine crash. So how do you get good quality sleep? Sure, it's the number of hours you sleep, but it's also how deeply you sleep, meaning how often are you aroused at night? And that's something that usually you're not aware of, but certain things can affect the quality of sleep. So if you have sleep disorders like sleep apnea, where you wake up and you find yourself struggling to breathe and then fall back asleep, or your partner might tell you that, or you're having restless leg syndrome where your legs are moving quite a bit, or if you've had a lot of caffeine or alcohol late in the day, that can affect the quality of your sleep. And interestingly, we are the only species that actively tries to limit our sleep. Every other species goes to sleep at around the same time every day and wakes up around the same time every day. So I mentioned that caffeine may disrupt your sleep. And it's not that you may have difficulty falling asleep. I have plenty of times drinking caffeine late in the day, particularly when I was in training, and I would fall asleep quite easily. But it does affect a number of wakenings you have and makes your quality of sleep more poor. Similarly, alcohol will disrupt certain stages of your sleep and make you wake up more frequently throughout the night, producing lower quality sleep. So you can see the effects of sleep deprivation if, of course, you don't sleep for a night or most of the night, but it can also build up if you've had multiple nights where you've slept maybe 6 or less hours, and it can cause cumulative effects which can be more difficult to recognize. The first way that sleep can affect your quality of life is that it can affect your what we call cognitive function. So it's your ability to perform tasks or respond to tasks appropriately. So when tasks are really easy and repetitive, it can just take longer for people to respond. But when they become more complex, it can really affect your ability to perform optimally. In fact, in certain small studies, they found that even 3 days of sleeping less than 6 hours can affect your ability to perform optimally. Another thing, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with, is that not getting enough sleep can actually affect your mood, right? So many of us have been sleep deprived and we're more irritable, more maybe depressed or anxious. And if you've got chronic sleep deprivation, you're not allowing yourself to sleep enough at night, that can become a chronic state of being. But if you tend to restore that sleep and get good quality of sleep, you will find yourself to be more happier, less irritable, and increase your energy. The other really scary part about not sleeping enough is what we call microsleeps. So if you've ever been in a situation where you've been sleep deprived and driving, you may actually remember having microsleeps in your car where you stop at a red light and you fall asleep for a couple seconds and wake up. These are essentially not under your control. You can open a window, you can blast the music, you can do all those things, but they're not gonna stop that drive of your body needing to sleep. And if you're driving when that microsleep happens, it can really cause a serious car accident, which can lead to paralysis, death, and so many other horrible consequences. And in fact, excessive sleepiness is the cause of half of all truck crashes in the United States. Half. Sleep can also affect your heart. So in 2016, the American Heart Association released a statement that essentially said having sleep deprivation is a cardiovascular risk factor. And the reason for this is that when you are in lack of sleep, your body revs up your sympathetic nervous system. And your sympathetic nervous system is kind of your fight or flight system. It's what your body does when it's in a state of stress. It needs to run away from like a lion that's chasing you. And during this time, your heart rate and your blood pressure go up. They did a huge study in the UK of 500,000 people who had no history of cardiovascular disease, and they looked at people who slept for less than 6 hours, just chronically slept for less than 6 hours, and they followed them over 7 years. And they found that people who slept less had a 20% higher risk of a heart attack or a myocardial infarction. 20% just from not sleeping enough. Interestingly, sleeping over 9 hours was also a risk factor for having a poor cardiovascular outcome. In another study, they looked at 4,000 people who didn't have any heart disease or sleep apnea, and they looked at those who had less than 6 hours of sleep a night, and they used ultrasound to look at a couple major arteries in the body to see if there was plaque buildup, which is what we see in patients who have heart disease. And in fact, those who did sleep less than 6 hours had a higher burden of what we call atherosclerotic plaque in their arteries. Also, there's some concern that sleep deprivation can put you at higher risk of obesity, diabetes, or what we call metabolic syndrome. And I'm sure a lot of you can relate. Me personally, when I'm sleep deprived, I'm way more likely to eat snacks and eat high carbohydrate processed foods rather than eating whole natural foods. And they've actually looked at this in some small studies, and they found that people who are sleep deprived have higher levels of ghrelin, which is a hormone that stimulates appetite, and lower levels of leptin, which reduces appetite, which causes people to have more cravings. They've also done some small studies where they've sleep deprived people and given them free access to food, and they found that people who were more sleep deprived tended to eat more high carbohydrate foods, about 300-600 calories more than the groups that slept well. And lastly, sleep can actually affect your immune system. So they've actually done a few studies where they've looked at the response to getting the influenza virus or the rhinovirus, which are both meant to help prevent you from things like the flu or the common cold. And what they found is that people who are sleep deprived have either a less robust response to the vaccination, or they're more likely to get the cold when they're exposed to it if they're sleep deprived. Bottom line, sleep is super important. And in my next video, I'm going to give you guys some actionable tips to help you sleep at night. So make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.